Scott said lightning is the overriding theme in this morning's storm.
It's already been an issue for one family overnight. WLKY's Eric King is live on the waterfront with a look at a house fire that was caused by lightning and to tell us what he's seeing out there right now. Eric?
Yeah, it's been dramatic, and I don't use that term lightly. Straight over there where you see that series of lights, there was just a big streak of lightning that came down. I initially thought it was a hit. I can't obviously confirm that. That was just my initial thought, but there was a big streak of lightning that came down over there. It's been just a big light show for a long period of time that we've been here. Let's take a look at some video, kind of editing together some of the lightning that we've seen over the past hour. This, as you'll agree, is quite extreme, and it's only going to continue throughout the morning. I'll tell you, as of right now, there are about 600 customers who are without electricity in Jefferson, Bullitt, and Oldham counties. We cannot confirm as of right now whether or not that has anything to do specifically with the lightning or the weather itself, but at the very least, 600 people at least are without power right now in those three counties, Jefferson, Bullitt, and Oldham County. I just shot a call over to MetroSafe to find out if they were working anything weather-related as of right now. They're saying that they are not, but they're certainly on standby. As far as the fire that we've been talking about over the course of the morning is concerned, this happened around 1:20 this morning at a home in the 4700 block of Wolf Creek Parkway. That's off of Springdale Road in eastern Jefferson County. When firefighters got there, the family who lived in the house had already made it out. It still took fire crews about 20 minutes to knock the fire out.
We confirmed everybody was out. Crews immediately went upstairs to the second floor, gained access to the attic, saw a small amount of fire that had made its way through the roof line. Majority of the fire was contained to the outside of the house.
Now back out here live at Waterfront Park, if you were with us about an hour ago when I was on the air, I was kind of giving you some clarity of the live shot that you're looking at. We're standing under Interstate 64 just because we're paying attention to our own personal safety here. So if you hear a lot of rumbling, it's because of the car traffic that's going over the interstate. Also, if you were with us an hour ago, you know I was talking about if you're seeing some water drifting into the shot, it was because of the sprinklers that were on the waterfront on the Great Lawn. That's no longer the case. It's raining, and it's raining very hard now. But as you saw from that lightning display a bit earlier, you might see a couple of flashes going on behind me right now. It's something that you should certainly pay attention to as you send your kids out to the bus stop this morning or drive your kids to school. It's certainly a safety situation. Lightning, certainly nothing to joke around with. Live here at Waterfront Park, I'm Eric King, WLKY News.